Close on its heels is Tata Motors, where in pre-opening it's down nearly about 4.5%. Remember, the ADR was down 8% over there. Rohan Kordi, the auto analyst at Prabhudas Leeladhar, now joins in. Hi, Rohan. Good morning, and thanks for joining in. First, have you cut down your estimates on Tata Motors, and what would your view be on the stock?
Yeah. So in terms of estimates, obviously because of the relatively weaker results in the fourth quarter, as well as the outlook on the possibility of JLR margins being lower on a YY basis in FY16 will weigh down on the estimates going forward for the next year. Also, there was a 5% dilution to the rights issue which took place a month ago, so that also is getting factored into the estimates at this point of time. So that does lower the estimates. But in terms of outlook, I think moving on from FY16 into FY17, I don't see any reason to drastically change estimates or anything. I think the benefits from local production at China, which we thought would come in FY16, that is not going to happen. But I think FY17 onwards, performance would be better over there. We'll also be seeing the ramp up on some of the products like the XC, which is taking place in this year, and the full impact should be visible in FY17. Similarly, the F-Pace would be launched, and other newer models which will be coming in. The Discovery Sport is yet to be launched in China in the second half as a local production. So all those things will impact positively going forward, but there will be a couple of quarters of pain in the near term.
Okay, so a couple of quarters of pain. Rohan, hi, morning. The pain has already been felt on the stock. I mean, the stock is down more than 15% from its record highs that it hit in the month of February. Do you think all of this transition period pain has been factored in, or do you expect to see more downside?
Well, it's tough to say whether the entire thing has been factored in. I think if the volumes are not going to pick up for the next few months, then you can't really say that all the pain is factored in, but I think the extent of it is much more visible than what it was, say, even 3 months ago, where we probably underestimated the impact of lower volumes in China. So I think once the volumes start picking up the second half onwards, things should be much better. While I think the bottom in terms of volumes volume growth as such probably has been there. I don't think China sales will be going down further from their current levels.
Okay, so just to get in a few estimates for FY16, what would you pencil in by way of JLR volumes for FY16, as well as, on the margin front, because that's where some disappointment came through this quarter for JLR?
For FY16, I'm looking at 5.4 lakh units, and in terms of margins, I'm looking at 17.5%.
Okay, so 17.5% margins for FY16. That's not much of an improvement compared to what they've done this quarter. What is your target price on the stock, Rohan? And for for someone who has perhaps not invested in Tata Motors, is this a good time to be buying the stock considering it's come off so much?
Yeah, one thing on the margins is that we are looking at the margins coming down from 18.9% to 17.5% in FY16. So mainly looking at the full impact rather than simply analyzing the fourth quarter impact. And the other part is that, yes, the stock, from a long-term perspective, definitely even at current levels.
Okay. Just one more question on the standalone business. I know it's an extremely small part of the company, but the fact that we have seen an EBITDA positive number after six quarters almost, do you think that could give the stock any respite?
Directionally, it's positive, but since it does not form a significant part, then it's not a game changer for me. But it's always good to see the leader in the situation, India, turning out any performance. On passenger vehicle as well, that will be having new launches every year. That's a positive, and if they can regain some part of the market share, it's definitely not going to be bad for them. But as I said, it won't be a game changer for me.
All right, Rohan, we'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining in. By the way, the rupee is starting.